How do you do? I'm Dr. John Sase. Welcome to Urban Economics, Advanced Topic Number 8. In this video, we will develop a one input, one market, mill to port, non-linear model. By defining and summing input transport cost and output transport cost to get total cost, we will determine the optimal production location at either the input location, large I, or the market location, large M, or at some point in between. This treatment continues the example introduced in topic 7. However, in this variation, we will use nonlinear cost functions such that they will determine only one optimal location for production to occur. We begin by graphing an input transport cost function. This function increases at an increasing rate as we leave the vineyard and approach the market. We could assume that moving a truck filled with fresh grapes into a densely populated area with crowded surface streets will gradually slow the process and increase the cost per mile. If production were to take place at the market location, the input transport cost would reach its maximum of point large I star. Next, we graph an output transport function. This function decreases at a decreasing rate as we leave the winery located at the vineyard and we approach the market. We could assume that moving a truck filled with cases of wine bottles into a densely populated area becomes easier because the truck can use high-speed expressways as it gets closer to the city and the wholesale district of the marketplace. If production were to take place at the vineyard, the output transport cost would start at its maximum point of large M star. As in our linear example, we add the input and output transport cost functions together. We can determine the total cost of transporting fresh grapes and wine bottles from any point of production to the market. In this nonlinear case, we determine the optimal production location by finding the point at which total shipping cost is minimized. For both quadratic expressions, the vineyard location, large I, is the y-intercept. At the y-intercept, we let beta 0 be the cost of shipping output from the vineyard at point large I. This cost is greater than 0. Likewise, beta 3 is the cost of shipping input from point large I. Naturally, we expect this cost to be 0. The variable mu is the distance in miles plotted along the horizontal axes between the vineyard and the market. Therefore, we can express the cost of shipping output, the cases of wine, as beta 0 plus beta 1 times mu plus beta 2 times mu squared, such that beta 1 is negative and beta 2 is positive. We can express the cost of shipping input, the lugs of fresh grapes, as beta 3 plus beta 4 mu plus beta 5 times mu squared, such that beta 4 is positive and beta 5 is positive. As the price of wine, the cost of grapes, and the labor costs remain constant, see the topic in video number 7, the curvature of the total shipping cost curve has a minimum point at some intermediate value mu and can be expressed as beta 0 plus beta 1 mu plus beta 2 mu squared plus beta 3 plus beta 4 mu plus beta 5 mu squared. Grouping the terms to get a simplified quadratic equation renders the sum of beta 0 and beta 3, which must be positive given our definition of these two y-intercepts, plus the sum of beta 1 and beta 4. We expect beta 1 to be negative and beta 4 to be positive, times mu plus the sum of beta 2 and beta 5, which must be positive, times mu squared. In short, if beta 1 is of a greater magnitude than beta 4, there will be a point mu somewhere between the vineyard and the market at which total cost will be minimized. We can determine this value of mu by taking the first derivative, in other words, the marginal cost, of the preceding equation, setting it equal to zero, and solving for mu star. Effectively, rearranging the marginal cost equation as mu equals the negative of the sum of beta 1 and beta 4 divided by the product of 2 times the sum of beta 2 and beta 5 will return the solution mu star, the optimal distance away from the vineyard and toward the market. This works because both beta 2 and beta 5 are positive, and we expect the absolute value of beta 1 to be greater than beta 5. Returning to our graph, we see the value mu star at which marginal cost is equal to zero at a point tangent to total cost. For this winery, mu star represents the optimal location to place its production, returning fresh grapes into bottles of wine. I hope this has helped you. If it has, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment for topics you would care to view. Thanks and have a great day.